five year. I welcome you to Rim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through mathematics form 3, lesson 5. The topic it is the quadratic expression and equation 2. I'm your tutor, Lucy Modoni. Welcome. Our lesson goes today, we are going to look at the formation of the quadratic equation and solving them. And we also look at the real life situations, questions. Before we come to the real life situations, the first thing you're supposed to recall, we need to know the quadratic equation, how they are formed, how they look like, how we try to solve them. For example, when you look at the whatever that is on the screen, we have different ways that we can get the equation. We can have y is equals to x squared plus 8x minus 16. That is a quadratic equation. We can also have that negative 2x squared is equals to negative 8. That is a quadratic equation. We can also have the x squared minus 5x plus 4 is equals to 0, a quadratic equation. The same way, we can have x squared plus 6x is equals to 72, and also x squared plus 16x is equals to 44. All those are equations that it can be presented to you, and you are required to take it back to the quadratic equation and you solve the equation. So that is now in mathematics way. Now let us look at another example. This is now the real life situation. We have the diagram that is given there, and then you are told to find 8, or you are told to show that the 2x squared plus 17 minus 100 is equal to 0. That is a quadratic equation. So we need to form a quadratic equation from the diagram. That is the way we find the perimeter. And then finally, you are required to get the perimeter of the trapezium. Now, generally, the formula of finding the area of a trapezium, we just take A plus B divided by 2, then multiplied by the edge. So that is what you are supposed to take. I would take my A, B, my A, which is supposed to be x plus 7, my B, which is supposed to be x plus 10. Then my H, is supposed to be 8. So in that case now, that is the reason as to why you can get the equation there that we are getting to. It is x plus 7, then plus x plus 10. We cross the bracket, multiplied by the x, then divided by 2, which is supposed to be 50. Remember now we have been told, or have been given, the area of the trapezium is 50 centimeters squared. So with that now we can solve the equation. So we multiply both sides by 2. So in that case now we get that 2x plus 17 in bracket, then x, that is bringing the right terms in the bracket or solving the number that is in the bracket, is equals to 100. So with that now, finally, we end up having 2x squared plus 17x minus 100 is equal to 0. Already you have shown, or we have formed, as we were expected to do. Now from there, we can solve for x. Then finally, we get the perimeter. Remember, the perimeter is supposed to be the area all the way around. We take another example. The length of the rectangle is 3 times its breadth. If the breadth is decreased by 2 meters and its length increased by 4 meters, the area of the rectangle is decreased by that. Find the breadth of the original rectangle and find its area. This is the way you're supposed to take it. Let the breadth be x, while the length should be 3 times x. So the area of the original rectangle becomes 3x times x, which is equal to 3x squared, as you can be able to see. The dimensions of the new rectangle, remember the breadth has been decreased by 2, and the length has been increased by 4. So with that case now, we have the new area should be x minus 2, multiplied by 3x plus 4. So in that case, now we have 3x squared plus 4x minus 6x minus 8 is the new area, which is 3x squared minus 2x minus 8. The difference now between the two areas, now we take that difference, that is the original area minus the new area. So with that case now, when we subtract, you get 2x plus 8 is the difference, which is supposed to be at the end of the original area. And when we equate it, we are going to get x squared minus 2x minus 8 is equal to 0. Solving the equation, you are getting the x is equal to negative 4 and x is equal to 2. Remember, this is the length, so we cannot give it being negative, so we take positive. So my x is positive. Therefore, our x is equal to 2. The breadth of the original rectangle is 2, while the length is 6. So the area becomes 6 times 2, which is equal to 12 meters squared. That is the width supposed to be calculated in real life situation. Let's take another example. We have a rectangle here. Then we are given the show that it is equal to that. And then we are supposed to fight for the x and then find the area. This is where supposed to be, take the dimensions and remember the Pythagoras theorem. That is what you are supposed to do. A squared plus b squared is equal to c squared. So in that case, now we have the 2x squared plus 10x minus 37 is equal to 7x squared minus 22x minus 33. Which we get 7x squared minus 22x minus 33 is equal to 0. Already you have shown what you are supposed to do. After that, we find the value of x. Remember, we said we can use any formula, and the one that I've used there, it is the quadratic formula. So with that now, after replacing the values, we just get x is equal to negative 1.1 and x is equal to 4.25. So remember, this is the dimension, we cannot take negative, so we take 4.25. With that now, we get the area, which is now A is equal to 1/2 times 3.25 plus 10.25. Not plus, but times 10.25, which is giving us 16.25 centimeters squared. Then activity for today, this is the assignment you're supposed to do. A positive two-digit number is the product of the digit is 24. When the digits are reversed, the number formed is greater than the original number by 18. Find the number. This is now where you are required to form the quadratic equation, and then from there, you solve the equation. Reference, you can get more information from the KJRB 2003 Secondary Mathematics Student Book 3, that edition. For more information, you can contact us through the SMS. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook. You can also get us, or you can also Twitter us through that. So otherwise, stay tuned to Erim TV. Thank you.